When someone passes, where do they go? Gone forever, or can they show? What if you could find someone between to bridge the gap of those unseen?
I see departed souls, and I'm able to communicate with them. I get messages from beyond, from your lost loved ones. You may be surprised at what they have to say.
Ladies and gentlemen, here she is, the one and only Michele Livingston. Hey, Michele, good to have you with us, sweetheart. How you doing?
I'm doing fantastic. Back for the month of love.
Can you believe it's February 1st already? I am just shocked how fast January flew by.
I know. I met my husband this month on Valentine's
Day. Oh, wow.
Special month for both of us. And thanks, everybody, for being so patient. We're here.
Yes, we're here. We're here. And Michele's in, again, Pennsylvania. I'm here in Hollywood. We do have another show now right before Michele's show, so it does cause a bit of a delay with getting everything on time, unfortunately. But we're working on that. We're going to work it out in our schedule so that we're more on time and everything, and we can work out the kinks, because sometimes we run into technical snafus right before we go live, and that's what happened today. So I want to apologize to our audience. Thank you for being patient and waiting on the lines. I know that people are already calling in, Michele, which is great. They are already calling before the show, usually. They're so excited to speak to you, which is great. Yes. And so we're talking today, though, about your book, Living in the Afterlife, correct?
Yes, we are. And because it's the month of love, John, I thought we'd dedicate several Wednesdays to our loved ones in heaven and how to communicate with them. And if anybody would like a reading, call in. I'd be more than happy to give you one. Cool. And also, I have some confirmations. I usually read them from last Wednesday.
Great ones.
Good confirmations. Somebody watching the show had a near-death experience. And we were mentioning the tunnel, the portal between this world and the heavenly realms. Mm-hmm. And she said hers was amazing. She said hers was bright purple. She was out for maybe a half an hour. And emerald green sparkles. And she said she didn't want to come back, you know, after she went through her beautiful tunnel. So that was a confirmation. Sharon, God bless her. I saw balloons with her. She said she was 54 years old. Her husband had passed. And I kept saying February, and she couldn't think of anything. So she emailed me and said, Michele, you won't believe it. I'm getting my diploma. I went back to school, and I graduated because my husband inspired me to, and my diploma arrives in February. Those are the kind of things that come in. Kathy, I think last week
yes.
did reincarnation, and Kathy said the French cloisters really hit home. She loves France. And there was one other one. I'm on a number one drive time show in Pennsylvania for the last 10 years. I was on this morning, and a gentleman called in, and he had some guilt attached to the passing of his dad, because he didn't make it down to Carolinas and Virginia in time. So he held on to that guilt. And his dad came through this morning on the radio and said, son, I love you like a friend. Release the guilt. Some souls do not want to see us or people watch them take their last breath, because they don't want that memory to be the last memory that we remember of them. So after that, a lady was listening, of course. It's a pretty big range there. She broke down in tears. She went to the cemetery this morning and asked her grandmother and grandfather for forgiveness, because she didn't make it to the end time when they took their last breath, either one of them. And she sent me a picture, John, and it's in winter here. You know, it's the dead of winter. It's February 1st. There was a bright pink flower right in front of her grandmother's grave, which she picked up, and she sent me a picture. And she knew her grandmother was saying hello, because her grandmother loved a garden. This is this morning. And then she got home, and her coffee maker was on. She didn't have it on when she left, and her grandfather loved coffee. So she said to me, thank you so much, because even though you can't see who you're talking to, you know, you're touching a lot of us. And it was just a beautiful thing. So I'm thanking everybody, honestly, for confirmations. I have another one, too. I'll just hold it up quickly. It's an angel holding a butterfly. And I had a reading with a lady whose granddaughter passed, God bless her, at the age of 14, her granddaughter. And what came through in her reading was, you'll receive an angel holding a butterfly, and that's your link with your granddaughter. And honestly, here it is.
Wow.
There's the angel with the butterfly.
Yeah.
And so it's wonderful to have these validations, these confirmations, because people are searching for love and for where are my loved ones, whether it's a spouse or a girlfriend or boyfriend for Valentine's or just a loved one, mothers, fathers.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why I want to devote this month, John, the month of love. Yes, those we have loved, but have really never lost.
Right.
You know. And so keep the confirmations coming in. It's nice to share them.
Yeah.
It helps other people. Really, it does.
It really does.
We're back.
So they can write on your Facebook page. That's Michele Livingston, 1L, the People's Medium. That's on Facebook. And
they can send my email to Michele with 1L at michellelivingston.com.
Okay,
that's
great.
Where I get a lot of them.
Great. All right.
And also my fan page and also my regular page. So
okay.
Facebook.
Yes, yeah. We love Facebook, and we have a lot of people on Facebook Live. I just want to remind you, we don't see your comments until after the show, so if you could go to UBN Radio, click on Channel 2, and enter in your social media login, and you'll jump in the chat room with us, and I will do my best to relay questions, comments, observations to Michele throughout the show. And again, so click on UBNRadio.com, Channel 2, and log in with your social media, and we will see you in the chat room.
Actually, the chat room gets you faster.
Yes, it does.
If you write a message or so on, because a lot of people look at my fan page, The People's Medium.
Mm-hmm.
They try to call in and they have to wait a really long time.
Yeah.
And I say, go to the chat room. It's UBN.
Yep.
TVRadio.com.
Right.
You'll get in channel 2.
And yeah. I'll normally be in there. I'm using the name Spirit Speaks at the moment. Just to let you know, I will ask for your area code and the first three numbers of your phone number so that I can find you in our call center. We have an independent call center that does all of the calls, and then we route those calls into the studio. Okay? Just to let you know. All right.
The East is still trying to figure out the West.
Right.
It's so nuts.
Yes.
I'm going to fly out there to Hollywood. And I'm
so you can
actually,
see it all. Yeah.
I'm actually going to come on the show, my show.
Yeah.
I'll be in the studio with you and
that'll be
else.
Awesome.
That.
Yeah, that'll be awesome. You can see the studio and see what I'm doing behind the scenes and all that great stuff. We'll have a great time.
It.
Yeah. All right, so again, the phone number 323-649-8268 323-649-8268. We are discussing today Michele's book, one of many, Living in the Afterlife: Experiences from the Soul Place.
Yes.
And it's an incredible book. It is available on Kindle. It's available online. Also through Michele's website, michellelivingston.com. But if you don't want to wait for it to be shipped to you, you can get it, you know, digitally.
Yes.
Which,
or Barnes & Noble or Amazon. And if you want it signed, it's on my website. So I will, if you order it there, be more than happy to sign it. We've sold a lot of these, John.
Yeah.
I'm so happy. I
can see why, because it's an incredible book. I told you when I first, you know, I was introduced to you through James, and we had you on, and we were talking about this book, and I was asked to read this book, and normally I'm like, oh, I got to read a book before an interview, but I did. I couldn't put it down. I loved it. Absolutely loved it. I just had it on my phone, on my computer. I was reading it everywhere I go.
Thank you. It's an easy read.
Yeah.
And I don't know how many people write to me and say, boy, my fear of death is out the window now.
Mm.
You know, the greatest fear is the fear of public speaking.
Mm-hmm. No,
and the fear
true.
Of death.
Yeah.
I don't know if you know that.
Yeah, no.
You probably do. So, they're passing it around to their the baby boomers and their grandparents. And people feel comforted to know that they're going to be by loved ones and their pets.
Mm-hmm.
Pets are big.
Yes.
You know, as far as the love, the unconditional love goes. And so if anybody tonight misses someone, whether it's a companion, spouse, girlfriend, boyfriend, or even grandmother, grandfather, mother, father,
mm-hmm.
I'm here for you. We'll see what we can come up with. And I really enjoy the show. John, you're wonderful. I just posted your live.
You're reading my mind. It's so crazy. It's so crazy.
Know,
I was just thinking how incredible you are. Now you're going into how...
No, I just posted your unedited live meditation.
I know.
Yeah. Everybody's raving about it.
Oh,
and
thank you.
I say in caps, and he had his eyes closed. That is amazing.
Yeah.
So you're being led and guided. And that's fabulous. And you should be so proud.
Oh, thank you. Well, you've encouraged me all along the way. And I, you know, I'm just blessed to have you in my life. I really am. You're a blessing to so many people, Michele. You really, truly are. You really, truly are.
How much I love you, John.
So I love you too. All right. So we have a lot of people in the chat room, new people in the chat room, actually, that are joining us from Facebook Live. So they are getting the message, which is great. So folks in the chat room, please let me know what your area code and first three numbers are, and I will get you prioritized here in the queue if you're already holding. If you're already holding, please let me know. All right. So Michele, let's talk a little bit about your book. Especially like you were mentioning earlier about the portals, and you gave us some confirmation about that for folks who maybe not, you know, tuned in last week.
Absolutely.
Yes.
And I know each week we have some new people.
Yeah.
And I want to say that 4 years ago, and I will say this again, I didn't know I'd be writing a book on the afterlife, but my mother came through. She was an English teacher. She said, guess what? She came through from heaven. You're going to write a book on living in the afterlife. And I want to tell you what it's like. Hmm. 33 souls came through, John, which you know.
Yeah.
Some were celebrities. Some were well-known singers. Some were just family members of mine and clients who had passed.
Mm-hmm.
And so anyhow, it was a four-year project. And what came out was a fascinating exploration of how we leave our body, how we go through the connecting portal or tunnel. Everybody's tunnel is different because everybody has a different view of life and the passing, death, and a different personality. So they describe their tunnels, some of them. There's also rehabs in heaven, which I found was fascinating.
Wow, yeah.
So if somebody has a drug or alcohol problem or a hoarder.
Mm-hmm.
Remember when I was
sure.
on James Bond Club show?
Yeah.
And I met my stepdad, Ted, God bless him, who was a hoarder.
Mm-hmm.
Everything went weird.
Yeah.
And they said, come on, Ted, get out of here. And everything cleared up.
Electromagnetic energy, yes.
That's right.
Yes.
You got it.
Uh-huh.
So the soul is energy. You can never destroy the soul.
Mm-hmm.
And what I found was interesting is everyone that mentioned what it was like in heaven had a different viewpoint. But we all do supposedly go through a life review. We're not judged by an angry creator on a throne, but we have to literally review our life objectively, our first breath to the last. And then we can work and study and learn in heaven, musical compositions, which you're dealing with now, art,
yeah.
Writing, creative writing. Einstein came back, which is called Paradox, which you talked about last week, to give the world what he had to offer.
Mm-hmm.
And along with famous, like Leonardo da Vinci, artists and authors and so on. It's a fascinating thing.
It really is.
Realm.
Yes.
Yeah. Huh. And there's suicide mentioned in the book,
mm-hmm.
which is interesting, and the different levels of why someone took their life.
Mm-hmm.
And there's no condemnation with it for those listening and watching. The only downside is we contract a timeline,
right.
Soul contract. So if we take our life at 20 and we've soul contracted 40, we're out of 20 years of development.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, and you have always told me about astral world.
Yes.
Yeah.
Astral city.
To
astral city. Yes.
Yeah, exactly. What is it? Astral.
Astral
whatever.
City. Yes. Uh-huh.
I love it.
Yes.
Portuguese, but it is the gray area. It starts out with these sub area.
Uh-huh.
People that have murdered or whatever's happened, traumatic passings.
Right.
And then they try to work their way out through love,
mm-hmm.
and through service in the next world. So thank you so much, John, because it took me about 3 months after you told me about it. But people are talking about it.
And they're working on a sequel. So I'm really looking forward to that. Yes, because they do this in Brazil. So this is, you know, Astral City was Brazil's biggest movie ever put together. And so they're doing a sequel. Yeah.
Fantastic. And What Dreams May Come with Robin Williams.
Yes, incredible.
That's one of my favorites, too. People ask, well, which one is your... Yeah, there's so many of them. But he was such a wonderful actor. And it's very interesting because in that movie, there's a section on suicide. His wife was down in the gray area, if you watch it.
Yes.
And she took her life after he passed, and they were trying to meet up. It's just an eye-opener. It really is.
Mm-hmm.
And that was back, I think, in the probably early 80s that came out, John. I don't know what dreams may come with Robin Williams, but it's a great movie.
It is, and you know, they have it on Netflix from time to time, so if people have Netflix, they can watch it on there. Yeah. But yeah, it is a great, great movie. It's interesting because, you know, it starts out when he crosses over to the other side. He's in a painting, you know, and I never really got that the first time I watched it. So when you go back and watch it a second, third time, you really get a lot of the, you know, detail that maybe you've missed from when you watch it the first time, because it's a very deep movie.
Very deep movie. Yeah. And even his children on the other side, who he meets,
yes,
have transformed into different figures. His daughter, I think, was an Asian girl that came to him.
Yes.
His son was an African American that came to him. Mm-hmm. It just shows that there's no distance with love. There's no race, creed, or whatever. We're all God's children.
Right.
And the technicolor, him running through the fields flowers that turn into
beautiful
paint,
paint
explosions. It is wild.
Yes.
You don't even need a drink to watch it.
No, it's very surreal, and that's what I was telling you a few shows back about taking you into the virtual world, because that world is recreated in that virtual world where you can actually walk through with your avatar and experience it in full depth. It's incredible. Yeah, so we're going to get you there.
Okay, I'm there.
And nowadays, I've been seeing all these advertisements for a Samsung VR, and you can put your phone into a goggle kind of apparatus and be immersed just with your phone. It's incredible what technology is today. So you don't even need a high-power computer to do what
Is incredible.
Yeah.
My 5-year-old granddaughter knows more than I do about all this kind of thing. Can you imagine? It is true.
Well, you know, the reason I bring it up is because people are using it for meditation, relaxation, for spirituality. They're really using it as an outlet to disconnect from the world and really bring in the beautiful visuals and peaceful, you know, it really creates an incredible
And really with artists like you and me, when I paint, whether it's Asian rice paper or cloud paintings with pastels, I zone into a different dimension. I really do. That's what the creative process is all about. And it's a meditative form.
Yes.
And I need to get back to it. Just like when you compose with your eyes closed, that's a meditative form of composition. It's a wonderful way to unwind, step back from the crazy world that we're in right now, and meditate. And people say, well, how do I meditate? Well, the old thing is, you walk down a path, you can meet your spirit guides, the old theme, I mean, or there's so many ways. When you're involved with something and your mind's in neutral, like art or music or craft or, you know, anything like that, it doesn't even have to be that creative. When your mind's in neutral, you're in neutral. And that helps you to stabilize. It really does.
Yeah.
We were talking this morning on the radio, People's Morning Show, about the bombardment with the political situation, which I'm not going to get into.
Yeah.
But everything you read goes into here, and it could be positive or it could be negative.
Yeah.
So I always keep my posts on Facebook. I try to inspirational.
Me too.
And uplifting for the day.
Yes.
Right. So people have something to go to.
Right.
Beefy, like, oh boy, that sets me off. I choose to be happy today.
Right. Yeah, it's a safe, positive space. Because, you know, social media, especially as empaths, we absorb all of that energy as we're scrolling through our newsfeed. You know, I posted something recently about social media for sensitives, because it really is important to be careful about what you're absorbing, just like the news. Be very careful about what you take in as a sensitive. You are more, it's almost like we don't have this shell of protection unless we place it there, you know?
Yeah.
And you've talked about shielding.
Yeah, and that's something people need to be aware of.
Mm-hmm.
Shielding every morning, white lighting, whatever it is. James Von Prague has some great shielding techniques. Yes, he does.
Mm-hmm.
And even getting in the shower, and visualizing golden light, or even visualizing the chakra colors.
Right.
If you get in the shower in the morning and visualize the sparkling light, but then purple is the highest spiritual color, then indigo blue, aqua. In other words, if you close your eyes and visualize the drops coming down, the emerald green, the yellow, golden yellow, orange, and ruby red, just like jewels.
Yes.
And you'll feel balanced.
Yes.
That's another thing. People write to me, well, I've done your Epsom salt baths. I've
they
done your
sure have. Mineral. Yes. It's working.
Yeah. But that's another way to compound it mm-hmm. and make it really great so that you're balanced. Because you know about photography. Well, there's curly in photography,
right.
but also people's auras have been photographed
sure.
many times.
Yeah, no.
When we're down, we're a little ill, our aura tends to shrink. But when we're happy, mm-hmm. we feel great, the aura expands. And it's all about color and even wearing color. You know, I have this color on, not just for Valentine's, but it's the color of love. Pink is the color of heart love.
Yeah.
Not in the chakras, but in the spiritual heart.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. Interesting.
It is.
So.
No, it's interesting you brought up the whole shower thing because I did that yesterday. Exactly what you just said. I mean, we were so connected. It's crazy in a good way. But I did. And I actually felt led to bring in the music that I played and play that while I was in the shower. And I turned on the rainfall setting so that it was like the rainfall, you know, and it was just, and I did the visualization of the chakra cleansing and all the negative energy flowing down into the drain.
That's, yeah. So you step out and you're energized and balanced
mm-hmm.
and you can go about your day. And it really does help.
Yeah.
I mean, people say, well, how's that going to help me?
Right.
You try it. It'll help you.
It really does. And I did it in the evening, you know, just to decompress from the day. Yeah. Because
yeah.
I know some people start their morning that way too.
And it'll help you sleep.
Mm-hmm.
I know that you're a night owl like I
am.
So we'll bring it down, John.
Exactly. That's why I did it. Yes. I went right to sleep right after and woke up 4 hours later. And
yeah. Like a baby 4 hours later. You don't sleep a lot.
Well,
do
it's a segmented sleep that I'm doing. I don't know if other people, you know, the spiritual community, but I went and researched a little bit. It's segmented sleep. You sleep and have a real deep sleep for a few hours, and then you get up and you do other things, and then you go back to sleep hours later. It's segmented sleeping, and you can look it up. It's very interesting. I don't work with the circadian rhythms. That's for sure. I'm out of this world. All right. Well, let's get to our calls, Michele, because we're already 22 minutes in. And I see some people in the chat room who are also in the call queue. So let's get to our first one. We have area code 718 on the line. Can we have your name,
okay,
please?
Come on, get to asking some questions.
Hello. You're on the air with Michele. Can we have your name, please, and where you're calling from?
Hello? Hello?
We heard you there, 718. You're there on the line. We have you on the line.
Did you
Hello?
Disconnect?
Hi. Hi. Hi, you're on.
Hi, this is Nicole.
Hi, Nicole. It's so good to talk to you, my dear. How are you tonight or today?
I'm doing okay. I was just, my sister had passed away unexpectedly about a year and a half ago. It was just me and her. We were so close. We talked maybe 15 to 20 times a day. And I just miss her so much. And I see little signs like ladybugs. And I just feel hurt. I just want to know anything that you could tell me.
Absolutely. And I'm so glad you're open, Nicole. I love that name, by the way. Anything, any creature, honey, with wings are symbols of the soul. Ladybugs are big. Red's the color of health mm-hmm. and vitality. And that's the covering of the ladybug. But also...
But you have disrespectively...
But also butterflies, birds. Watch for uh-huh. red. Your sister liked red. So that's where the you watch cardinals. Where are you calling from, Nicole?
I'm calling from New York.
Hi. So Hi. Watch for cardinals from your sister. Bless her. She didn't have an easy life. I think I have her through. When I say that, she was very sensitive, as we were just talking about. And she got very emotional. But do you know she loves you? She was very tight with you. I don't know if you're on my fan
yeah.
page. I wish you would be, because
yeah.
she crosses her fingers. I don't know if they ever called you Nikki or just
yeah.
Nicole. But she says Nikki.
Nikki, she called me Nikki.
I know, darling. She says Nikki. Hi, it's your sister. You know I couldn't let this go by without saying how much I love you. And she says, watch for the winged creatures. Because you have gotten yourself down, darling, since your sister passed, but with other things, because you're very sensitive yourself. Music's good for you, Nikki. You should listen to kind of calm music, not crazy acid rock or whatever it is, but calm music. Mm-hmm. Your sister, listen to me. She loved there's a real pretty fragrance that's coming in from her. And I also have to say that somebody lived in row homes or tight quarters. Now, I don't know if this was you or her in New York growing up. So it could be rows of homes. Do you understand? Not a big palatial place, but tight quarters. And is your dad, is your dad passed, Nikki? Is your daddy passed? Okay, I have him through, darling. I don't know if there was liquor that he enjoyed or somebody enjoyed liquor. I'd have to be honest with you. He's a character. Mm-hmm. He clears his throat. He says, hi, honey. He says, hi, honey. I got your sister with me. He says, I tried to provide, but I wasn't always emotionally available, if you understand what's being said. Thank you, sweetheart. Because your dad's a good person. But when we go through our life review, we see everything that we have done on Earth. And he loved his family, I think, more than you know. I don't know if he left. Did he pass young or did he leave you? Or there's something with...
Yeah, he passed very young.
I thought so. Because I'm not feeling emotionally connected with him and your family. But that's okay. But I need to tell you something, my precious. You are a survivor. You will always keep going. You have a big heart for people. And there isn't anything you wouldn't do for a neighbor or a friend, Nikki. I'm not kidding you. And this is the month of is the month of love. Your sister is a twin soul. I know there were times maybe you didn't quite get along. And other times you were joined at the hip. But she comes right on through. She has a great smile. She had a smile that would light up a room, your sister. And again, she crosses her fingers. She says, Nikki... She says, we were tight. She says, I love you. And she says, it's not your time. It's not your time to join me. So I know you've gone through some ups and downs, sweetheart. And I know you're getting a little emotional. But guess what? You have so much time left on Earth. And you help so many people. And I'm so happy to hear from you. Is this your first time watching, Nikki, and calling in?
Yes, it is.
I'm so happy. Thank you. And from my heart from my heart of love to your heart, God bless you, honey.
Okay. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, Nikki.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that was sweet. Yeah.
Oh, she says, oh, my. You know, you just never know. Let me tell you something. The soul that comes through to me, and you know this, John, retains their personality and their mind and their memory bank. Sometimes they ask for forgiveness when they come through. Sometimes they'll bring up memories from their past. Mm-hmm. I'm trying to get my earplug in here.
I see that,
see, everybody sees that. I have tiny little ears, and these things, I got to get new earplugs to show
them. Yeah. We'll get you small ones.
But no, what a sweet girl. Yeah. What a sweet girl. And I'm so glad that she was able to get through it. It's,
she was first in line. First in line. And actually, she came in the chat room, too. And I was like, oh, we'll get you right on. That's great.
Thank you, darling.
Yeah, that's great. All right. So let's move on to our next one. We have, let's see here, 773-771. And this looks like it's the guest name, so I don't have the name. So let's get it on the line. Hello, caller. This is John. I have Michelle on the line with
you.
Good. Can we have your name, please, and where you're calling from, please?
My name is Michelle, and I'm calling from Chicago.
Hello, Michelle. I know that name.
Yes.
Honey, is that one L or two L's?
I'm double L's, two
That's
L's.
All right.
And I just want to say you have such a beautiful smile.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much.
Yes, she
Bless
does.
You. Is this your first call now to me?
No, actually, it's my second.
Were you the one that confirmed your graduation, or am I off in left field? I had a Michelle call in
No, I think it was about, I think it may have been like 2 weeks ago that I got through.
Was it about your husband, honey? Or am I on the wrong Michelle?
If you have found one for me, then I would be, no, I'm just kidding. No, it wasn't about my husband. It was my my mother and my grandmother.
Oh, well, bless you. Because I had a Michelle whose husband passed, and I read her confirmation. She was two L's too, Michelle. And she's getting her diploma this month. And she's 54 years old.
Great.
And her husband inspired her, God bless him, before he passed away, to go back to school. And she wanted to know if he was proud
That's
of
amazing.
Her. Yeah. So you're the other Michelle with two L's. I'll remember you.
Correct.
Well, bless you. What's your question, sweetheart? What's your question?
Sure. I'm just wondering if my friends and my family and I have been with each other in past lives, because it just kind of seems like my best friend, her birthday, my birthday is 10/14, and her birthday is 11/04, and I don't know, maybe last year or something, we figured out, oh, duh, we're the same numbers.
Yeah.
And so it's just very weird. And I have a lot of really just like great connections with so many of my friends and then my family, of course, as well. And I'm just wondering if I've been through past lives with them.
Absolutely. Now, that was our show last week. I don't know if you watched, but reincarnation was our show last week. Your friend is a soul sister. She's not just a friend, Michelle. Soul sisters have been around the block many lifetimes together. And I do have to say that you can trust her. You'll always be able to trust her. Have you known her a long time, Michelle?
Oh, yeah. Probably going on 30 years, 30-some years.
I figured. Now, many times when we don't have biological sisters or when we're not getting along with them, we'll have a soul sister that comes in and is our best friend forever and we can trust. So let me ask you one quick question. Do you have siblings that are sisters?
I have one sister, yes.
Okay. We're not going to ask how you get along, but sometimes blood's not thicker than water. Sometimes our friends are closer to us than our own relatives. But yeah. And this is amazing, the October-November connections. I'm not a numerologist, but, you know, you came in a very similar time together, which means you've been around. So let me just figure this out now as far as past lives. One of you is much more organized. I get a kick out of this. This is what I'm hearing. Oh, it's a mother or grandmother figure for you. You didn't even ask for that. Michelle, do you have a mother's mother past? Can you tell me?
Yes. My grandmother.
Your mother's on Earth, though, is she?
No, my mother is gone as well.
I have both
and
of
so
them.
So is her mother.
Okay, listen to me, honey. I have both of them through. On the left side's mother and mother's mother. Hello, Michelle. We hope you wanted to... I trans-channel. We hope you wanted to hear from us tonight. Thank you for thinking of us over the holidays. See? So we just gotten off of December and so on. So you did think about them. They love your friend. They're so happy that you ask about her, Michelle. They're so happy that you're with each other. Because I'm telling you, you can trust this girl or this lady. And your mother and your grandmother and this sister, soul sister figure, have been in a past life together. And this is England. This is England. England, and it's probably 1800s. One of you girls, this is your soul sister, is more organized. I have to laugh about this. Mm-hmm. And one of you is a little more, not scattered, but carefree. So you're not cut from the same piece of cloth, you and this girlfriend of yours. You have different personalities, mm-hmm. but you balance each other, if you understand what's being said. Your mother's telling me that. You do balance each other. And sometimes this comes out, sweetheart. You need to give yourself a big pat in the back, too, because you help so many people, and you're very humble. But I have to say, you have that big heart. You do have that big heart. Your mother's very proud of you. I don't know how you got along with her. She passed. Mm-hmm. I don't know if it's a little unexpected, but I feel like there was maybe some unresolved issues from your dad or mom's side. There was something that was not resolved. I don't know if you understand this. Either you weren't there.
Yeah.
What can you share? Please share that with me, just very quickly.
She died early. She died young at 60. She had multiple sclerosis. So, but like my father and her had divorced when I was in college. And, you know, it just was kind of just the whole thing was just kind of a mess.
Exactly. So as far as a male figure goes, father, mother, there was some dissension there. She's made peace with it all. She's hoped that you and your heart, Michelle, have made peace with it. I think you have. And you need to go. You need to go to Florida. Where are you located again? I forget. What did you say?
I'm in Chicago. Chicago.
Have you ever been to East
I'm
Coast?
I'm in Chicago.
Michelle, have you ever visited East Coast?
Not recently.
Have you been to Florida, darling?
Yes, I have been to Florida, yes. Not recently, though.
You're going back, Michele. You're going back either with your girlfriend for a visit or something. I don't think it's Disney World, but I don't know, with kids, you know, younger kids. But have fun in Florida. Your mother's waving. Have you ever been to Disney World, honey? Have you ever been to Disney World?
I was in Disneyland with my mom, you know, and I remember that. I was only 3 or 4 years old when we went to Disneyland in California.
That was California.
But I've never been to Disney World. Right.
Well, you and your girlfriend laugh a lot, and you have that inner child. You need to go to Disney World in Florida. You'll have a blast.
Okay.
And thanks for calling, and bless you, sweetheart. You're a wonderful person. Thank you.
Oh, thank you so much for your guidance.
Bye-bye, hon.
Have a great day.
Thank you, Michele. Take care, hon. All right. Yes. No, that's great. So you were seeing her going to Disney World in Florida.
Well, she's going to Florida. I don't know if she has grandkids, but she's going down to Florida for something. And, you know, Disney World's just not for kids. I mean,
no.
I love it.
I want to check it out myself. As you're talking about it, I'm like, I want to go.
Epcot Center. John, it's fabulous.
And they're adding Avatar World to it. And
I know.
Yeah.
And virtual reality.
Yes.
All these kind of things. You would go crazy.
I would. You know that 100%. All right. So let's get to our next caller here. And I believe we have a relative of Araceli who's in the chat room. So she's coming up. So she's on area code 305. Is this Victoria? Hello, 305-333. You're on the line, hon.
Yes, hi.
Okay, great. Is this Victoria?
Yes.
How are you doing today?
Good. How are you?
Hi, Victoria. How are you? My goodness gracious. I'm glad you got through. Have we talked before?
No, we haven't.
Well, I'm glad to talk to you. Thank you for calling. And where are you calling from, Victoria?
I'm calling from Fort Lauderdale, Florida.
Oh, I'm headed there in May. I've been asked to do a seminar in Florida around the Fort Lauderdale.
Wow.
Yeah, around the Fort. We have a condominium in Fort Lauderdale, but anyhow, I was asked to come down there to do a seminar. Maybe you can join me. It's in May. It's towards the end
Hopefully.
Of May. Oh, I'm so glad. I want to meet you. I want to meet you.
I do too.
So, darling, what is your question? Do you have a loved one that you'd like to hear from, Victoria, or what would you like to ask me, honey?
Yes. My grandfather, I was hoping that you could get in touch with my grandfather that sadly passed away before I was born.
Yeah. Well, guess what, honey? He's a spirit guide. I don't know if you watched the show before, but a relative, when they pass, will train to be a guide of one or two people still here on Earth. Your grandpop's a spirit guide of yours. Where do rosary beads come in? Is there a Catholic that you know of? You have a friend Catholic? Is there Catholic in family?
Yeah, we're at, my whole entire family is Catholic.
All right, darling. So this would be, he would be Catholic. He's also with a lady, though. I don't know if his wife's passed or he's with another. He's with a female, and they're shaking rosary beads. That's how I know Catholic. He's been sending prayers down for you, Victoria. There's some good changes, my dear, you're going to go through. So it's nothing negative. You always put your best foot forward, Grandpa tells me. He's not very tall. You have a picture of him, I think, but you've never really met him, I know. But you have a picture of him. He had a big heart. He's talking about the old country. Come to the old country. Come to the homeland. Now, where would that be for you? I'm serious. He wants you to get on a plane and come to the homeland. Where would that be?
I'm guessing Cuba because he's from Cuba.
All right. That would make perfect sense. And somebody liked drums and music that he was with when he was in Cuba. Cuba's a great place to go. And you would love it because you're a sun person. You're not a winter person. You're a sun person, darling. Do you have a picture of him? He shows, he holds up a picture. You must have an old picture of your.
I'm guessing my parents do, but I've seen plenty of pictures of him before.
Yeah, he was a good-looking gentleman when he was younger. And see, the thing is, we're in soul groups in heaven, sweetheart, up to 5,000, 6,000 souls. Your grandpa is a member of your soul group in heaven, and he had your soul with him before you were sent down to your mama, okay? And is your daddy still on earth, honey? He acknowledges your daddy, too. Is he on earth? Victoria, Vicky.
Yes, he is.
Would you please tell your daddy to go get a physical? He has a little bit of a stubborn streak. I have to laugh. Some men do. But I do have to say your dad needs to get his blood pressure checked and his heart. He's fine, but Grandpa wants him to go do that. And there's changes for you, and they're all good, Vicky. I'm calling you Vicky. Your spiritual development has really fast-forwarded in the last 2 years. Do you realize that? Your openness, your empathic ability to spirit. Do you understand that? Feeling energy. And being open to
yeah.
spirit. Yeah. Guess what? Your grandpa is helping you with that, darling. Is helping you. And then there's oh my goodness. Where's the J initials? J. Oh, Ja? Joe? Joe.
My father's middle name is Javier.
Well, you see, that would be Spanish, right? So, yeah, that would be, and that's J. Again, that's his way of acknowledging your daddy. Mm-hmm. I don't know if your daddy's girl. I don't know if your daddy's girl, but I can see you're very pretty. Honestly, I can see you. And your hair is beautiful. And try not to straighten it too much, your grandpa says. I don't know what that means. I don't know if you straighten your hair and it's kind of
I have very, very I have very, very curly hair and it gets poofy, so I like to straighten it a lot.
Yeah, he's showing me your hair like an afro. He says, tell my granddaughter not to straighten it too much because that's a part of your personality. You're very creative, and he likes your hair all curly. So anyhow, Victoria, God bless. Thank you so much for watching and for calling.
Oh, I have an extra question.
Real quickly, Hello? Darling. Yes, real quickly.
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry. I have a big test on Saturday, and I was hoping if you could tell me if there's a possibility I might pass.
You're going to pass. Didn't I say there were good changes coming up for you a while ago?
Yeah.
And that's
I was just like, oh, my gosh.
And that's the pride that your grandfather has as a guide. So I want you to thank him tonight before you go to sleep. Just say thank you so much for being in my soul group. Thank you so much for helping me through life. And I really do love you. And what that does is it'll pull his energy down. He's going to help you with the test. Yeah. You have a photographic mind, darling. I got to move on. But you do. Once you see something, you tend to remember it. That's how you learn. So he'll be with you right there. So bless you, Victoria. Have a good night.
Thank you. Thank you, Michele.
Aww, bye-bye, thank you,
honey.
Victoria. Take care. Sweet. That was funny. We went right to Florida right after we were talking about Florida. I had no idea that area code was there, but yeah.
Oh yeah, I'm going down there in May for a seminar. That's not till May, John. So we're going to take it 1 week at a time.
Well, right. But you do have a seminar coming up, right?
Yeah, I do have one April 2nd. It is in Central Pennsylvania. I think we have a clip of it.
We do. Yeah, so let's get to that and we'll come right back, okay?
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
You got it, sweetie.
If you enjoy The Michele Livingston Show and want to see her in person, check out her next live seminar.
So here we go. If you can work with me, close your eyes. We're going to take 8 deep breaths and we're going to start.
Have you recently lost a loved one?
Who lost a husband recently?
She did.
I had to take a deep breath with him. I feel it was fairly quick.
Could you be the next one to get a reading?
I think I'm with you, sweetie. There's a name like Bree. They're showing me cheese.
My dog.
That's a new one. They showed me Brie Cheese and her daughter's name Brie. See how this works?
This seminar will provide an experience that will truly enhance your understanding of the other dimensions.
When we get over there, we train to help one or two people that are on the earth plane, and we train to be their guides or their helpers.
And confirm that you...
There's a dad figure coming through here.
...are never alone.
Did you enjoy it?
All right, and we're back. Brie Cheese, that was a really funny one. Tell us about that, Michele. It's funny.
Well, they'll do anything. Oh, I'm echoing, John. Why am I echoing?
I hear you fine. I don't hear any echo.
Okay. Spirit, when they come through, mm-hmm. will give me any symbols to get me to say something.
Uh-huh.
So the lady's daughter's name was Brie, and they showed me a big chunk of Brie cheese. Just like I think it was last week, uh-huh. that her husband came through and showed a watch, was shaking a watch.
Yeah, yeah.
And it was their password together to get to the other side. So the only way to visualize that and give that to me is to literally show me a mm-hmm. symbol
yeah.
to get me to say something. Because they're working telepathically. They're not, we know that.
Right.
They're not working physically. And some personalities of souls are stronger.
Yeah.
And they're more characters and their personality shines through. Others are more timid.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, that was really funny.
Yeah, it really was. No, I love that. It worked.
She looked so shocked. She's like, oh my gosh.
It totally worked. It totally worked. And that's great. Now, you had mentioned before a passcode or a password. So to explain to the audience, what that meant is that they have a word that they share that if the medium was to mention that word, then they would know that they're connected. Is that correct?
Right.
Okay.
She did not get into specifics, but she said it was a code word.
Yeah, right.
And it took her a while because I had mentioned, if you weren't watching, I think it was last week, mm-hmm. he kept shaking a watch.
Mm-hmm.
And she said, I have his ring, but I don't remember his watch. I don't think I have his
yeah.
watch. But he was persistent. He kept shaking the watch.
Right.
And then she said, because I try not to cut people off. I get excited. She said, I know exactly what you're talking about. Watch was our password for heaven.
Yeah.
So well, no, but it meant something to her. As long as it means something to the person
yeah.
that I'm doing a reading for, that's all that matters.
And Irene in the chat room says she's from Canada. She spoke to you a couple weeks ago. And you told her that she was going to dream of her husband very soon, and she did 2 nights ago. So she just wanted to let you know that.
Thank you.
And Andrea in the chat room is saying that she wanted to mention about shielding, that she's added a couple things to help her. After she clears her aura and her chakras, she throws the stuff that no longer serves her into a larger imaginary violet flame. Then she rinses with purple and pink and seals herself and puts mirrors around her so that she has control of her veil and her filters and her emotions.
That's fantastic. You should write a book, my dear.
Andrea, I've recently started talking to her on Facebook. She's got a lot going on energetically.
She's really a beautiful soul.
Yeah,
she's
yeah.
an old soul. And I have a feeling with her passion for life that she's going to be doing some writing.
Mm-hmm.
And some of these things that she's mentioning to us, she should be writing down
yeah.
and doing a little booklet, honestly.
There you go.
Go ahead, darling. You got to start this.
There you go, Andrea. Yes, and Araceli is in the chat room. I think that's how you pronounce the name. And that was her daughter that you had spoke to just the last call in Florida.
Victoria.
Yes, uh-huh, Victoria,
yeah, right.
Yes. So she wanted to thank you. She says that she's freaking out right now and crying for all the wonderful things that you just shared. So, yeah. So, folks, I just want to remind you, this show is live. So we have a chat room. We relay messages back and forth. It's all interactive. You come and be a part of the show. Please share the show with your friends. Hit the share button
yes.
right now. Share it with your friends. Let people be
yes.
a part of this experience. It's incredible. We have a great time doing it. So.
You know, this is about, I think it's my 16th episode.
Yeah.
And it started, it was so funny because I'm the only pioneer in Pennsylvania
yeah.
in the East, really, that has my own show. It's all LA, it's
mm-hmm.
all Hollywood out there
mm-hmm.
because you have such a wonderful studio. So I thought, well, let me give this a go. And
yeah.
it started with local calls, and it's been fantastic.
We got North Pole calling, Michele.
Yeah,
remember?
And I really do this to help people. I love people, to touch people. And this is a platform for me to get the word out
to
many people, not just in my little corner of central Pennsylvania.
Yeah, no, and with the power of the internet and, you know, and technology today, thank God, right? We really are. And that's really kind of how we're communicating telepathically. We're all sort of just all connected as a network, and we're sending instant messages to each other, you know, and it's pretty powerful.
And you and John are telepathic. Me and you.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. 100%. Really strong. Really strong. Okay. Well, let's get to our calls. I know I can feel them saying, get to it already.
So, we can feel you because we're an empath.
All right. So we have Samantha coming on the line, 573. Samantha, hi. Samantha, are you there?
Yes.
Hi. You're on the air with Michele and John. Can we have where you're calling from, please?
Columbia, Missouri.
Great. And do you have a question for Michele?
Samantha, can you turn your volume down, honey, on your computer or radio or something? Yeah, it's echoing a little bit. Hi.
Okay, is that a little bit better?
Yeah, thank you so much. So,
no problem. How are you?
I am great, my dear. Thank you so much for calling. Did they ever call you Sammy or is it always Samantha?
Sammy's been called a few times.
Okay. Because I have a soul coming in. Sorry to not even ask you a question. There's a soul coming in who's a gentleman on the mic calling you Sammy. And wow, you haven't had it easy this lifetime, sweetheart. But boy, are you keep going. Do you keep going, darling? This would be Grandpa or Pop. Doesn't mean you have to like them. I always say that. People laugh. And it doesn't mean you have to know them. But he admires you for your courage. You know, you'll step right into the unknown. You'll step into something that doesn't feel quite comfortable, but that's who you are. You're a survivor. Do you understand what he's saying about you, Sammy? He calls you Sammy.
Yeah. Yeah. It's my grandpa, Sam, who I was named after.
there you go. I was going to say Sam, too, or Sammy. He watches out for you more than you will ever know. And he tells me... He's proud that you are his namesake, that you wear the name well. You wear the name well. And you're actually, this is funny, you have a lot of attributes that are not so much masculine, but they're direct and they're survivor type attributes and they're communicative. See, those are male attributes. And I really want to say your grandpa's around more than you know, your namesake. You're his namesake. No. Okay, let's get back to your question. Because I had to get him through. Sammy, which would be your question?
No problem. I actually was hoping to be able to, you know, communicate with my brother a little bit.
Your bro.
He passed away recently, and it's been pretty rough.
I know it has been. That's why your grandpa said that. Depression is in family. I don't know if you know that, honey. That's clinical or genetic. I think your brother, he had such a good heart, but he got himself down a little bit. And did he go out fairly quickly, Sammy? By the time, you know, something?
Yeah.
Yeah. There's no pain issue with him. Who smokes or who smoked? I'm smelling it so strongly. I'm going to tell the spirits to get it out of here. either brothers... Either brother smoked or you smoke. I'm not kidding you. Who would have smoked? Can you tell me?
Both of us. I really need to quit.
okay. I have your brother through. And he says, take these darn smokes, and he throws them in the corner. He just bunches up the container. If you need, listen, in my book, my darling, Messages from Beyond, there's a chapter on how to curb smoking. I don't want to lecture you. But it came from spirit, and you take one cigarette out of each pack per week or per day. I don't know how you smoke pretty much, and you flush it down the toilet. So you're not tempted to go back and relight it. And then the next day you do two cigarettes out of the pack, the third day, three. Your brother says you have long life, but he's not concerned about your respiratory. Sammy, if you're not careful, there could be emphysema or bronchial complications, honey, or asthma with you. All right. Yeah. He is very dressed down. He felt misunderstood a little bit on Earth. I have no idea what that means. Now, who was in the 40s? Who's in the 40s, in their 40s? Isn't that nutsy? Can you tell me? I don't know if he was in this. No, really. Yeah, I don't want to ask your age. And I'm not talking about being born in the 40s. Somebody's 42, 45, 47 in family. So there's an acknowledgement. Right. There's an acknowledgement of that person that's still on earth in family.
Okay.
Do you know he got depressed, Sammy? Do you understand or not?
Yeah.
His condition got him down or the genetic predisposition for it. I don't know how long he's been gone, but boy, he wants to look happy. And he says, thanks for your thoughts, Sam. He calls you Sam. He says, thanks for your thoughts of me. And thanks for if you prayed for him. I don't know what you did in his honor, in his memory. Although somebody may have gotten a tattoo, darling, too, or thought about it. I don't know.
There's a few of us, actually.
All right. He is acknowledging those that have gotten tattoos in his honor or who thought about them. And he says, I'm not an angel, so forget the wings on the tattoo.
Nice.
He said, if you want to put eagle wings, that's different than butterfly wings. So he had a mind of his own. He knew what he wanted. He went for what he wanted. He's made it to the light, honey. He made it to the light, and he did what he had to do. Sam, I don't know what that means at the end. He did what he had to do. So if you understand that, that's between you and me and your brother.
I do.
All right. Okay. So I thank you, darling, for calling, and I hope you keep watching. It was so nice to talk to you.
Thank you. So nice to talk to you. Thank you so much.
And listen to me. Native American Indian cigarettes without the filter are even better than what you're doing now, okay? Native American Indian cigarettes.
Okay.
Bye.
All right. Thank you, Samantha.
Oh, my gosh.
Thank you.
John, you never know what's going to come out. I mean, honestly, it gets crazy.
And it's very important that you mention that because that's what it is. You just listen. You're the messenger. You deliver. You can't question. You can't doubt yourself because that will affect your ability. And it's very important that you just get it right out, right? So that's why.
And if you see me looking left or right or whatever, that's where they come in. Mm-hmm. See, I visualize the one girl with the cute curly hair.
Yeah.
What I do is I see the person in my mind, and then the spirits come in around them. And that's so if I'm glancing this way or that way, it's father's side, mother's side, children in the front, in-laws and friends in the back. So you'll see me glance around.
Yeah, yeah. No, that makes total sense. Even like, you know, when people are trying to remember things, their eyes go to the left or to the right, I don't know which way, but goes, you know, to a different direction, and they're pulling stuff from the past or the future, right? That's what it means. Yeah, so, all right. Well, I want to mention that Stephanie in the chat room says that what was confirmed about the Victoria's hair, the caller before, was a creative personality is exactly how she feels about her curly hair. I barely ever straighten it because I feel that it flattens my personality when I straighten my hair. So that's what you were saying earlier about how the grandfather was communicating that he doesn't want her to flatten the hair. He wants to be part of her boyish.
And Stephanie, I love you. She writes to me a lot. She's open to spirit.
Yes.
We have a good time. We communicate back and forth. So thank you, darling. Keep your hair all curly.
Great.
Well, that's part of your personality.
Well, remember earlier I was mentioning about Andrea and doing the shielding, and you were saying for her to write a book. Well, I've got Andrea on the line. She called in to just give us a few words. So, Andrea, you're on the line.
Hey. Hi, guys.
Hi.
Hi, little one. How are you?
I'm fantastic. It's so awesome. I feel selfish taking up anybody's time, but I adore both of you, and you've changed my life so much. I do not know what led me to you, but I'm just inspired every time I listen and see your smile and hear your voice, John, and you just do such wonderful things for people. You come from a purely unconditional love space, and it's wonderful.
Thank you. And I appreciate you communicating. I also think you're going to be doing some writing, my dear. You're very evolved. Oh, my gosh. You've worked on yourself. I'm hearing your spirit guide. This is not a relative. This is a spirit guide saying Andrea has worked on herself for a long time.
Mm.
And I mean, like 18 months, 2 years, 3 years, you have made a conscious effort. I don't know what that means to help yourself. And you've done a fantastic job, darling.
Have. Yeah, I hear the word adept.
I actually was.
A-D-E-P-T.
It's funny, I pulled a card for myself today, and it was Ascension card, and I actually was diagnosed about 8 years ago with a chronic debilitating disease known as Crohn's colitis, and I was taking all kinds of medication and suffering, and I used canes, and I did not look like myself, and I basically had a life-changing experience that it was hard and long. I don't want to go into it, but basically I was able to realize that when you let down all those negative talks in your mind, yourself opens up and it is pure love and you can visualize, manifest anything. I literally printed a piece of paper. It's funny you talk about writing and I manifested.
What?
I will on this date feel good, be cured, be off all this medication, and do this for the good of others and everyone. And it was dated 2 years ago.
Oh,
and I pulled
wow.
it out and I showed my daughter, and she was just amazing. She said, I think you need to contact my best friend, and she needs to write your book. And it's just so funny that this is all just happening.
Mm.
No, you do. That's why we have connected.
Yeah.
And I know you love John's music, but and I know this is a cliche, Andrea, but you're an old soul. You've been around to be able, see, we can cure ourselves through thought. We can do anything through our thoughts. And you've been able to harness in to that track of love. And
mm-hmm.
we were talking about this morning when I was on this Drive Time radio show. There are two things in the world, love and fear.
Mm-hmm.
People think it's good and evil or good and bad or love and hate. It's love and fear.
Yes.
So everything negative, dis-ease, or anything that is not for our highest good is from the fear-based part
mm-hmm.
that comes in on us. Everything that's positive and happy and uplifting is the love-based.
Yes.
So I'm very proud of you, darling. I've never met you, but for you to be able to make a list, do the I ams, do the positive thinking, and heal yourself through that channel of love is amazing. And you will. I want a signed copy of this book of yours because you're going to write it.
Thank you.
I do too.
Thank you. Yes, I will. You know, it's funny. I just said those exact same things on your Facebook page today. I said, fear equals dis-ease. I don't know if you remember reading it, but I wrote those exact same words, and I used the actual equal sign. And fear equals everything, low self-esteem,
yeah.
anger,
mm-hmm.
aggression,
yeah.
anything that's negative.
A disconnection from
and,
source.
You know, you need to know it.
Mm-hmm.
Right. But you need to know that in order to understand pure love. And it's just a balance and an understanding.
And John, you're on that wavelength. I can feel you right now.
Oh, yeah.
Something.
Oh, well, I was just saying it was disconnection from source is what fear is. It's feeling that you're not connected or, you know, that's and so that brings up all of the negative, you know, we were talking about the characteristics. You were saying the spectrum of love and fear. Yeah. No, and
it's interesting that you say that, John, because right now in the psychology world, they are eliminating the word addiction, and they're saying it's not really addiction; it's lack of human connection.
Yes,
and it is.
Mm-hmm.
It is. It is, and even touch, Andrea.
Yes.
Even if somebody's not touched, we know as a baby they can wither away, but as an adult, I get massage therapy treatments all the time.
Mm.
You know, my husband.
Guess what
I'm
doing? I'm going to Florida in 2 weeks.
Florida again.
Aromatouch therapy certified with essential oils.
Wow.
Good for you, darling. Oh
yeah.
My gosh, I'm so happy. And there's a rainbow technique too. You can go down the spine with the different chakra colors. You might learn that. I don't know what oils you're going to use, but yay! Florida's come up over and over.
Crystals. I've just been certified as a Reiki master, and I'm getting my crystal Reiki certification right now.
Wow.
So yes.
So do
I
you
am
know?
A powerful warrior.
You are. And do you know about the Merkaba?
Merkaba. Spell that.
Merkaba, Merkaba, and then look up the archangel. Oh, it was just in my head.
Azraela.
No, Michele, we talked about angels before, right? And
yeah.
And the Merkaba and the angel that's associated with that is...
Okay, tell us about the Merkaba, first of all. That's what everyone wants to hear about, John.
Okay.
What is Merkaba?
So the Merkaba is like a sacred geometry. So if you look up Merkaba, you know, I'll put up a visual of it right now so people can see. And there is interesting. I'm bringing up the visual right now, so just give me 1 second so I can display it to everybody to see in the screen.
It's like the Fibonacci code and the
right. And I'm
we talked about the harmonics.
Yes.
The
yes. Yes.
Yes. And I'm showing the picture right now, so people who are watching. So that is the angel with the Merkaba above. And it came to me when you were talking about doing the aura protection, when you were doing the shielding and all of that. So. There's a particular angels that really work with that field. And so I'm showing another picture. So I'm multitasking here, folks.
Okay.
Just bear with me.
Fantastic.
Yeah. So.
It's funny because I always call on Archangel Raphael just because I know
which is
his
the healer.
Healer. Energy always healed me. Correct.
Right. Right. And so Sandalphon.
Oh my gosh, that's so weird. I just drew that. I woke up and I drew that for no reason whatsoever. And I'm like, what is an octahedron? What is a tetrahedron? I just went crazy one morning. And
oh, well, there you go. That's why it's coming through so strong. And I got chills on that. yeah. So.
That's wild.
Yeah. So it's Metatron is the angel that I'm talking about.
Metatron, yes.
Yes.
Oh, yes. He's a huge archangel.
Metatron.
Yes.
Yes.
That's for you, my dearest. Metatron, you call upon him.
Yeah.
Oh my, I'm so excited for you.
It's going to take
That's
your healing
hard.
To another level.
But,
yeah. Wow.
Yes, I think that Ascension card really hit the spot this afternoon that I pulled.
Yeah. I'm so glad to hear from you, my dearest. And keep us posted.
Yes.
Let us know how it's going in Florida, okay? And I can't.
I most certainly will.
All right. Yeah, stay in touch with us, on. Thank you.
My next thing is to get John's music on the hold.
Oh.
So all the people can listen to John's music and hold for UBN Radio. Wouldn't
oh.
that be fantastic?
That's what I said to him.
Oh, thank you.
There you go, Andrea. Thank you.
I love you both so much. Love and blessings.
Love and blessings to you. Thank you, sweetheart. Oh, wow. That's what we do this show, right, Michele? It really
Absolutely.
Is. Just hear these stories that it's really impacting people's lives and that, you know, it's each one teach one. It really is.
Yeah. And it's so amazing that Andrea really opened up within the last 18 months to 2 years, which she confirmed.
Mm-hmm.
Once you're open, it's just like the snowball effect. More people come into your life, more doors swing open, you meet new people. When you're on the right track, you know it with
yes.
your life.
Yes.
You really do, because it's synchronicity.
Right. Right.
Yeah.
Okay, well, let's get to our next caller. She's been waiting patiently. Her name is Jill. And she's calling from 717. Hi, Jill. They're hearing me.
Hello.
Hi, Jill. Are you on the line?
Yes, I am.
Oh, excellent.
Hi.
How are you, my dearest?
Oh, we're doing okay. How are you?
I'm doing fine. It's so nice to talk to you. Is this your first time calling into the show?
Yes, it is.
Oh, good.
Yes, it is. I've listened to you on the People's Morning Show numerous times on my way to work. And this morning I started working from home, so I don't get to listen to it as much. And I drove my husband to work this morning and I heard you and I'm like, oh, so then I ended up watching your show from last week and everything. So I was very intrigued and always love what you have to say. So.
Oh, well, thank you. Thank you for listening and thank you for tonight, too. I appreciate it, Jill.
Yes.
Let me ask you something. Your husband, does he have a mother or father passed as yet, darling? An in-law?
My current husband or my late husband?
Well, it could be your late husband. There is an in-law wanting to say hello to you. And so
oh,
it's
really?
It's the present husband. They come in behind you. That's how I know. I see you very plainly. I won't describe it. It's so funny. But no, this is... you have a husband passed away. Is that what you're saying?
Yes. And
okay.
His mother just passed away last year.
Oh,
so,
that's it.
And I didn't get to see her before she passed. So.
Thank you so much. That's it. So I have your husband coming behind you with his mother. And it's your mother-in-law. She says, hi, Jill. She says, I got my boy.
Oh, well, tell her I said hi.
Yeah, I got my boy. She says, you were a really good wife. And she's thanking you for taking care of your husband emotionally or mentally or sending him love, even towards the very end. I have to say that she has a big heart of gratitude for you, sweetheart. You're a very loyal person, honey. Once you love somebody or befriend somebody, you don't turn your back on them. And that's a really strong attribute.
Not normally.
No, it's a strong attribute to have. You don't nitpick people. You try to give them the benefit of the doubt. And this is coming from your mother-in-law. It doesn't mean you had to get along with her when you were on Earth or if you even knew her, but she's thanking you for being with her son. Isn't that interesting? It doesn't happen a lot.
That is very interesting.
Now, who likes...
No, that means more to me than you realize.
Who like flowers? Who like gardening? Who likes to get out walking flowers, darling?
Well, she loved gardening.
Yeah, I know she loved gardening. I might have a new one. I smell all these flowers. Roses, lilac bushes. Oh, my.
And my mother did.
That's it. Okay, I can't go on and on. I get very excited. Your mother's passed away, honey?
Yes. Yes.
Oh, she's here for you, Jill. And she says, I love you so much. I had to say hello. It's the month of love. She said, I know we had our differences, your mother says, but in the end, there's nothing like love. Oh, I'm getting emotional. And she's letting me smell.
Oh, no.
Yeah, she's letting me smell beautiful flowers, too. So she wants you to know,
darling. Yeah, she loves flowers as well.
She wants you to know that in heaven, she's created a big garden for herself, your mother, with all the flowers that she loved. There's a patch of purple violets that she's created, your mother. There's rose bushes, and there's lilac bushes, and there's lilies. Oh, my gosh. So she liked all flowers.
The flowers run in my family. My mother-in-law did. My mother did. My grandmother loved flowers as well. So she was a big flower person.
And Jill, you're going to smell them. You'll just be sitting somewhere, and you're even in the winter like this, you're going to smell a potpourri of flowers, sweetheart. And those are from all the loved ones in heaven that really do love you, honey. All right?
Oh,
I'm so
awesome.
Glad your husband and his mother came through. That's very interesting. You know, it really is. And your husband now loves you, and you need to, you know, stay with him.
Mm-hmm.
When I say
definitely.
That, I mean emotionally, because he loves you very much. Okay?
I know he does. I know he does. And I guess it was just one of those things when my husband, you know, it was a sudden thing, a young age. And then my current husband now came into my life, you know, pretty quickly after that, you know, which was one of those things that you were, you know, held off on, that you weren't sure. And then there was times where him and I both believe, you know, that he was sent to me. There was a reason, you know.
Oh, absolutely. And listen, have him take you out on Valentine's Day, Jill.
Okay.
All right.
I will do that.
God bless
you,
darling. Thank you for listening this morning, and thank you for watching tonight.
Yeah, thank you, Jill.
Oh, yes, definitely. Yes, I appreciate it very much. Thank you.
Bye-bye, honey.
You take care and stay in touch.
Oh, bye-bye.
Okay.
Okay, we will. Thank you.
I need bigger ears.
I'm going to get you something with a hook so that it doesn't fall out. It's
I have such teeny everything. Teeny.
I see
ears,
that. Yeah.
And if this thing flies out one more time.
I know. That's funny. Well, we're just having a big old love fest today on the show. And that's what the show's all about. And we really are. I mean, with all these wonderful people calling in who's had readings with you in the past. And it's great. And, you know, Sharon was in the chat room. She was talking about, she was the one with the password. And I might have been able to find her. Let's see if
I hope so.
Is this Sharon? Let's see. Sharon 440, is that correct?
Yes, it is.
Hi.
Hi, Sharon. Welcome back.
Hello,
Hi,
darling.
Thank you. Hi, Michelle.
Hi, Sharon.
It's February 1st. I'm waiting for those balloons.
Oh, my gosh. You're going to get. Are you the one that's getting a diploma? Now, fill me in. I talked to a lot of people.
Well, you kept. You said something was happening in February. It was almost like a celebration with a birthday, or he was showing balloons. And I was so focused on, does he know I completed his dream? I completed school for him, and he said, and it didn't hit me that my official diploma, just like 2 days before, I got an email saying they're mailing it to me in February.
Okay, there you go. And were you the one where he said happy birthday in August, or am I losing my mind? Were you the August connection?
Nope. I am the August birthday, yes.
Oh, good, because my mind slips out.
Well, you do so many readings, it's understandable. You don't keep notes on any of this, so that makes sense.
Oh, my gosh, Sharon, thank you for confirming, because your husband's here again.
Oh,
and he
wow.
says, happy birthday, darling, August. And he says, happy Valentine's Day, but your diploma's coming within a week, he tells me.
All right. Does he know what job direction he wants me to go in?
What direction with your work are you asking, darling, or what?
With my career, now that I have to find a job and join the world again.
You will find a job. It won't be immediately. I'm getting, hold on a second, by April, it'll be a while. Yeah, get your resumes out. What you are going to be doing is well needed in this world.
What did you go to school for?
Business administration and marketing.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, and you're good. You're going to be good at it because you like people. Your husband tells me you're going to be great at it.
And never a shortage of marketing in this world.
Yeah, and do not lose hope, honey. Do not lose hope. You'll have to hear this. Patience is key. And it's not your age. We can all, no, I shouldn't say this. We can blame things on age, but it's not your age. The economy and everything's going to pick up. And mm-hmm. I'm telling you, by April, you get back to me. Something's going to open up that you're going to love. April. And your husband has a hand in it.
And it has a lot to do with technology, too. Marketing technology. It's not just the traditional marketing. It's another form of marketing.
Yes.
Yeah, so
awesome. We used to own a business together, and I've always been saying to him, Rick, I'm too old, you know, I'm going to pay back these student loans, and now what do I do?
No.
Isn't that funny? Age was just brought up.
Mm-hmm.
That, don't blame it on your age, honey. You got long life. You have longevity.
I appreciate that.
Listen, I am so glad you called in to confirm.
Mm-hmm.
Husband's love.
I wanted to share something with John. He is fascinated with my password, and I thought this might be interesting, you know, to your callers.
Yes.
My very first medium reading that I had after he passed, she kept saying, he's yelling clock, clock, clock. And I'm like, uh-huh. And she says, do you know what that means? Watch. And she's just naming all these things that had to do with time. And when he was alive, he was very adamant about passwords, and he'd have a password on top of passwords. And so it hit me. It's like, he's making me come up with the password so he'll talk to me. And that's why I named it Password to Heaven. And that is his personality to a T. But it also confirmed in my heart that I know I was really talking to him.
Exactly. Yes. Yeah. That's
and when you said that, Sharon, we were trying to figure that out.
Yes.
Because he doesn't say, guess what, password is clock and watch. He had to literally show me and shake it to get me to say it.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
So he was a very direct person in his thinking. Very direct.
Yes. Yes, he was. Yes, he was.
And he
Gotta
still
love
is.
Him.
I know. And he loves you, sweetheart, so much.
His messages are unique, he would say. Unique.
Yeah.
He got me going 17 years ago when my mother died in the afterlife and trying to find purpose and hope. And I never asked him, in all honesty, when he passed, you know, before he passed, because it was I didn't know it was happening, that if he ever really believed. But he knew that I believed, and I actually had an apparition of him. And it was the most amazing experience of my life.
What was it? Can you share it, Sharon? I'd love to hear that.
Well, I got an autopsy report. We had it done, and I was angry. I was going through those frustrations, like, you know, why didn't you share this with me? You knew what was going on. And, you know, I was just So I wrote him a letter because I've read all the books. I've read your books, and they always say, write it down. So I wrote him this letter, and early morning, I woke up, I looked by my door, and I had a full apparition of him. And he had that look on his face like, I'm sorry. No words, and then he was gone. And then I thought, oh, great, now how can I be mad at you? But it was a real moving experience. And my very first medium that I went to, I asked, was that real or was that my imagination? And he validated and said, no, it was real, an apparition. And she said, that's very unique to get one of those.
It's very unique because you were awake. See, dreams are the apparitions with them in the astral world. You're with them, but you were conscious, you were awake. Wow, that took a lot of energy for him to do that, Sharon.
Yeah.
That's amazing. Oh, I bet you're excited. Yeah. Thank you for sharing. Oh, that's wonderful. Mm-hmm. I'm so excited for you. And let us know how
you're... Thank you, Michele.
Hey, listen, let us know how your career goes.
Yes,
I'm
please
all
do.
For you. I'm for you, honey.
Yes, we're rooting for you.
Well,
stay
April, you said.
Well, around that time. In other words, your husband says you get impatient. That's the first thing. And he says you're working on patience and you need to take it 1 month at a time, not one day at a time. Well, then 1 day at a time too, but 1 month at a time. But by the breaking of spring, you know, Easter, April, in beginning of May, that's when things are going to open up for you. I don't get a date, but that's where the faith comes in, Sharon. That's where faith comes in. Okay, darling?
In the meantime, just keep studying up.
Thanks.
Keep those skills polished. You know what I'm saying? And then
I will.
Yeah.
And
then it's going to all fall into line.
I'm thinking, like Michele said, it's age. It's age. You know, I've got a lot of experience behind me, you know, with a business owner.
Right.
And then spending 5 years to go back to school because this is what we thought we wanted.
Right.
You know, the two of us. And now it's like, oh, great. What did I just do?
Okay, listen. You're Sharon, your husband's crossing his arms. He says, get over it. Age is just a number.
Mm.
Oh,
and that's exactly
okay.
What he's, all right.
And this is going to be fun for you to learn this new
Michele.
To learn this new stuff. It's all about it's really about expanding your skill set of what you've already learned, but keeping up with today's technology because that's where the job's coming in.
Yeah. Oh, thank you.
And look, you're connecting to us through newer technology. You're on a stream on Facebook. That's the future.
Right.
So there you go.
Future.
Yeah.
Maybe it's Apple. They've been looking at my resume, so.
Well, there you go.
There you go.
It's definitely technology. So I look forward to you calling us and giving us an update on that. All right? Thank you.
Well, thank you so much.
Bye-bye.
Take care, Sharon. All right. Wow, that was great.
That is great. I'm glad she got through to confirm.
Yes.
That.
Well, you know, that's what we say. Come into the chat room. If you're in the chat room and I can find you and we're talking about you, we'll get you on. You may have to call in, but we'll find you.
We'll find you.
Yeah, we're going to have to get the audio chat room where I can just hit a button and they can just speak into their computer and they're right on the air. It'll be wonderful, right?
And that's coming up. Yeah, that's going to be coming
up.
Yeah,
it is coming up. I've been talking about it for a while, so hopefully we'll get it soon. But Kathy in the chat room says, I love how you remember details about past callers. That's very sweet. And as many as readings you do, it's amazing that you do recall certain details. Mm-hmm. So,
I love people.
Yeah.
I don't remember everything, I do have to say.
No, well, who could? I mean, no. you know. Mm-hmm. And we have, let me see, another chat. So I'm looking, some people don't have their real name. It just has a guest number. But Jill earlier. Jill was saying that, thank you. Hearing from my mother-in-law meant so much. It gave me so much peace. Because I wasn't there when she passed and it broke my heart. And I just reminded her that, you know, she's always there. She's just a thought away. And you really, you know, it's great to have someone like you, Michele, that can connect because that helps us get out of our way so that we can have a direct connection with our loved one. But they really are listening to our thoughts and feeling
they
our thoughts.
They are listening.
Yeah.
There are things that do pull their energy down, like pictures.
Mm-hmm.
Our thoughts, our memories will pull their energy down. And that's very interesting. And, you know, you're so connected, John. I'm so honored to be working with you. I really am. There's a billion people in this world, and we happen to connect, and I'm so happy
well,
for
I'm
it.
So, I like I said, every show, I look so forward to you know, doing it with you. But you've become a real friend. It's not even just a show connection. This is a real friend. You've been a real friend to me. You always, and I wrote this out last night, and I was going to post it on your wall today. I haven't, you know, it's at home, but I remember what I said, and I said, your actions always follow with your, you know, your words, actually, always follow with your sincerity. your actions, because there's a lot of people who just speak and they never follow through. So I really, truly, from my heart, want to thank you for always following through. You've gone above and beyond for me, so I really love
it's
you so much.
It's the month of love.
It is, and that's what this is about. So we're expressing our love. So it's a love fest. And that's why the show is so great, because of the connection that everyone has, you know, in the community that we, you know, that we foster here.
Yeah, this is the community. This mm-hmm. is.
Yeah.
These are our neighbors, our community. And I think what's going to happen in the future is there's going to be almost, and I say this sometimes, a pebble dropped in the lake where all these concentric circles come out.
Mm-hmm.
So this is only my fourth month into the show. And I feel as this goes on, more people will be touched and helped.
Yeah.
And I hope for that. I really do.
The ripple effect.
This is my mission. The ripple effect.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
Wow. Well, we are in overtime because of the late start, but, you know, we're 25 minutes over. But do you would like to continue, or do you want to take a break?
Well, let's do one more.
One more. You got it.
I feel one more.
One more. All right. So give me a number from, let's just go from 1 to 5. Just give me a number from 1 to 5.
Okay. You pick, John.
You want me to pick? Okay.
Johnny. I'm hearing Johnny. Did they ever call you Johnny?
Yes, always. Family did.
I'm not doing a reading
Our
for you.
Family but... does, but yes. Okay. Well, let's get Jennifer on the line from 410.
Hi, Jennifer.
Hi. How are you?
Great. Good to talk to you. Have you called in before, honey, or is this your
yes,
first?
Yes, one time before I have.
Okay. And where are you located?
I'm in Maryland, not too far from you.
Oh, that's great. So do you have a question?
Yeah. Yeah, so I always hear people talk about seeing numbers and then being messages from spirits or angels. So I'm always, like, looking at the clock at 555 or... 111 or 222 or 1212, I see things like that.
Yeah.
I just wondered what it was supposed to be, the message or who, you know.
Okay, any double or triple digit is angelic. So 444 is a master angel number. And mine is 333, which is the triple trinity, which is powerful.
Mm-hmm.
Eights are amazing because when you turn an eight on its side, it's a sign of infinity. So eight's a power number. That's my soul number. So everybody vibrates, sweetheart, Jennifer, with a soul number. That's in my book, Messages from Beyond.
Mm-hmm.
So again, it can represent a month and a date. You know, 222 could be February 22nd, for example. That could be somebody's birth month or passing month. But most of the times, right, John?
Yeah.
Triple numbers or angels?
Yeah, sometimes I've been seeing 511, which was my address growing up, which I'm like, why am I seeing that? And, so there are certain numbers that you see, like 1111, 222, 333, you know, like the triples. And I believe that is just a reminder to you that you are connected spiritually, that you are thinking about your spiritual path. And they're letting you know that they're there to support you in that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Watch for numbers, darling. Not just the same numbers, same triple numbers, but also on digital clocks.
Yeah.
Anything flashing can become a date. Now, my papa passed February 11th. So lately, I've been seeing 211 when I look everywhere.
Okay.
And he's saying hello.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You get it? Yeah.
Yeah.
And with
it's like, I don't know, you second guess yourself sometimes thinking like, okay, really, you know.
But that's just your left—that's your left brain. You want to let your right brain interpret the spiritual meaning behind it, and because there's no such thing as a coincidence. It's all spiritual. It really is.
It's all spiritual,
yeah.
Jen.
Yeah.
It's all spiritual.
Okay.
And 1111 is a doorway. It's a doorway.
Okay.
So anytime you see 1111, you think of what you want to visualize before you go through that door, and then you're in that dimension of making that a reality. So that's
as above, so below.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a mirrored image. And I have a chapter in my book, Messages from Beyond, on 1111.
Yes.
So people born in November or the 11th day of a month are really spiritual seekers. And it's a decoding. When you see 1111, Jen, know that you're being awakened to spirituality. And please believe me, this is not your imagination. They're saying, hello. This is called awareness. It's called being open to what's beyond. It's not just all the physical world, you know, honey.
There's
a lot of communication. The soul within us, called the light body, it never dies. We go on forever. Mm-hmm. There's no time.
Yeah.
So the next numbers.
Yeah, I did. Go ahead.
Next numbers you see, write them down and write to me. I can have some angels interpret them even if you can't. Okay?
Okay, that would be great. That would be great. Yeah, I was just wondering, though, yeah, if they were angelic numbers or that's your loved ones sending you messages, or I guess it could be both.
It's all spirit. It's all spirit. So it's loved ones in spirit, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Angels usually take the same number and double or triple it,
mm-hmm.
or the spirit realms, like 1111. Your relatives will take a birth month, a crossing month, your birth month, and they'll flash it on a license plate, whatever, billboard. So watch for different numbers, too, because that's human souls, honey, saying
okay.
hello.
Great.
Okay? Yay!
Yes, thank you very much.
Thank you, Jennifer.
Thank you.
Yes, stay in touch with us. Let us know what, you know, observations, what comes up for you now that you've learned all of this through the show. And be sure to share it with your friends. All right, hon?
I certainly will. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
All right, now, Michele, before we wrap, I have one call that won't clear, so that's actually a sign to me that we need to take the call. So let's do the last caller, and this will be the final one, folks, unfortunately, of the evening. So it's 813. 813, you're on the line. Thank you so much for your patience. Can we have your question, please, for Michele?
Hi. When I was a kid, I would experience abnormal things. I was actually... sleeping, having a dream where something was chasing me, and when I woke up, I woke up to like a dark spirit standing in front of my bed. So I wanted to know what it was, because it actually made contact with me.
Oh boy. Okay, well, let me just talk. What is your first name? What's your first name?
Enrique.
Okay, and where are you calling from, sir Enrique? I'm
calling from Florida.
Oh, here we go.
Florida connection.
That's where I'm supposed to be, in Florida, between there and Lauderdale, doing this seminar. Thank you for confirming, Enrico.
Enrique. No, yeah, right.
Enrique. Yay. I like that name. That's a happy name.
Yes.
No.
Thanks.
Dreams, seriously, when you dream of falling or running or going underwater, your soul is out and has come back into your physical body. So when you were running, your soul was running back into your body. The dark shadow, I don't think it was negative. I really don't feel that. Many times in photographs, a spirit will take mist or smoky form, okay? So I don't feel it's a negative connotation. I really don't. How did you feel about it? You weren't scared, were you, Enrique?
I was terrified.
Oh, you were?
Because I was running in the dream. I was running down this hallway, and then when I wake up, I see this dark shadow in front of me. And as a curious kid, I went to put my hand through it, and it kind of like slapped me almost. It's kind of weird.
Ah.
And it slapped me kind of, and I felt the energy, and I kind of.
Is this in the dream or when you woke up?
Yeah. That's what I was going to ask.
Were you, no, this is when I woke up.
You were already awake. You're fully awake. You weren't dreaming that you were awake, right?
I was fully awake.
Okay.
Yeah.
And did it only happen one time, Enrique, or has it been several times? I want to know.
That only happened one time.
Mm-hmm.
I always told the story. I mean, I've always said it. And my parents, you know, when they wouldn't believe me, they were like, oh, you were just dreaming.
Okay.
But then, you know, as I got older, I kept with the same thing. I'm like, Mom, I know what I saw.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
I always like, you know.
And how old were you?
I was about 5 or 6.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
The curious thing, the funny thing is that I'm Adventist, Seventh-day Adventist.
Mm-hmm.
So when I would always like experience like abnormal things, like when I was a little kid, not like that, but I would see things. And then when I was baptized, I just stopped completely. I wouldn't see anything else.
Mm.
Well, children,
I was baptized like at 12.
Okay. And children, honestly, I say this, and this is true, in the formative years 1 to 5, their soul has not been in their bodies very long, and they're in and out a lot. Babies sleep a lot because they're adjusting to the earth plane. So I really don't deal with discarnate or earthbounds. Somebody wrote to me and said, what about shadow people? I really don't know, John. Do you? I've never experienced anything like that. Have you, John?
I've heard about it. I've read about it. I've also heard about sleep paralysis and things like that.
Yeah.
So I think it is, like you were saying, you know, there's many levels to the dream state and the dream world, the astral world. And I think that, you know, I personally would just, first of all, I feel that you're an empath. I mean, that's feels really strong, Enrique. So I would do the shielding. I would just do the shielding. I know you may not be experiencing this stuff now in adulthood, but there's still stuff that carries over that, you know, I'm glad that you said you were baptized. That cleared up since then. You haven't had these experiences. But do you know about empath, right? You do you know what an empath is?
I don't know. No.
Oh, okay. All right. So we've done shows about that. And empaths are people who imbibe other people's energy, and they can't tell the difference between their own energy and other people that they imbibe that energy from. So you're like a sponge. You're absorbing stuff. You're very sensitive. You pick up.
Yes, I am very sensitive.
Yes, I feel that really strong. Yeah.
I surround myself with people that bring me up because I can easily absorb energy and it brings me
down. There you go.
So I try to stay away from those people.
Yeah, that's empath.
And you'll have mood swings, Enrique, because you're if you're around negative, depressed people, you tend to go down.
Yep.
If you're around happy people, you'll go up.
Mm-hmm.
So empathic people have mood swings.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah.
And Michele, your books talk about that and as well. James has some courses on that as well. So how did you find us? I mean, this is interesting because you're learning about yourself through this, because I got that really strongly that you're an empath. And
it was actually through a friend on Facebook.
Oh, great. Someone shared it and you saw the show?
Somebody shared the video.
There you go.
And I started commenting with him, chatting with him. He said, you should call. And I said, you know, I'm really scared because I've never done this before.
Yeah.
I'm afraid somebody's going to say something negative or something bad, and I'm going to be scared.
We get that a lot, but Michele's all light. So she's never going to talk about the negative. If it's negative, it's going to be phrased in a positive, empowering way. So, but also I was getting that this form is the shadow self. Michele, were you picking that up at all? Like the shadow self. And the shadow self is parts of yourself that you haven't loved. So is there a part of you that maybe religion has not agreed with, or that you feel in conflict with your religion? There's something about, I'm hearing really strongly about searching out what your spirit is leading you to do, not so much what your religion is leading you to do, if that makes any sense. There's a difference between religion and spirituality. So follow your own inner guide, your own compass, and let that be what sets you free. That's what I'm hearing really strong. I got chills all over. So hopefully that's resonating with you.
Me too.
Yeah, definitely.
Good, good.
Well, Enrique, I will keep you in my prayers, sir.
Yeah, and stay in
Thank
touch
you
with
so.
Us.
Thank you. I really
so
appreciate
much.
It.
God bless.
Yeah.
And maybe I'll get to see you in May when I'm down there in Florida. I hope.
And you were
meant to
be on this call because I couldn't clear the lines, and we were trying to clear the lines. Michele's been over time. We're trying to wrap the show. So thank you so much for following your gut and making the call and having the courage to do so. All right.
Yeah, I guess it was one of those good spirits on my side.
There you go.
Push the line.
Yes.
100%.
Yes.
All right.
God bless you, honey.
Thank you
very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Take care. Wow. Okay, Michele. Are you okay? Did you run out of water?
Yes, I'm running out of water.
Okay, we're going to wrap then. Well, thank you, everybody. We had an awesome time tonight. It was Love Fest. Just Michele set the intention at the beginning of the show that we're going to talk about love, but we got to experience love, not just talk about it tonight. So, and that's why everything started the way it did. It ended on a real positive note. So thank you, everybody.
So thank you. Love you, John.
Love you too. Take care, everyone. Please share the show just like Enrique. He found out about us through sharing. So share. Come back and see us next week. And what we always say at the end of the show, Michele?
Always be kind.
Be kind to one another. Take care. Bye, everyone.
Welcome to the new sound of online radio. Welcome to the sound of Universal Broadcasting Network.
Cause you make me feel like I've been locked out of hell.
A mix of today's hits and hard-to-find favorites, combined with the most entertaining and intriguing talk anywhere. This is your sound. This is the sound of Universal Broadcasting Network at UBNRadio.com.